But I think we just like early birds. And I have talked with Dr. Aruchai and other people that we still not set some kind of QA standard yet, but we still learn from the others. So what I will talk about is just what we have done so far, okay? And maybe we need some kind of your suggestion after I'm show some details, you know. From as you know that the Thai MOOC project got the budget from the national level. We synergize previously for three ministries. First, Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Education, and Ministry of Digital Economy and Society. And we got some unit part that make under work with us too, like NSTDA and Office of Thai Higher Education Commission and OBEC and Secretariat of the MOE. So from this, but Thai MOOC now, like Thai MOOC Office Center is TCU. So TCU make it like a secretariat and also center to work with all nine regional network, network university hub. And from the hub we got, we try to contact them formal as we have, but actually we have a close relationship with the hub, right? And we got some kind of a 140 courses back after we try to empower the nine regional already. And we contact them a bit happened with like a budget problem, right? We contact very, very short time before September, and the budget have to sign and approve everything by the end of September. So right now still struggle with some things, I don't know. But whatever, proposal recruitment and agreement by TCU actually was helped by Regional University Network Center, as Dr. Chakun already described that PSU already help us to recruit some kind of courses from the local institutions. So the Thai MOOC right now we try to work like a network empowerment strategies also to move the whole country together. So from what we empower Regional University Network Center, we empower them for the first to help us for the proposal recruitment, and regional be a regional training center and also be a regional support center. But however, since the platform for the edX will use on the edX, Open edX, no one familiar with it yet. So before the network will be a regional support center, we train them before. So before the budget start, we try to go, have a meeting with the regional, and then go to set up small meeting and explain about the Open edX system and what we have to do for the design course, because it's different from the e-learning. And after that, even though the project already start since October, since August, September, we try to be training and education and give an education for the MOOC quality production to the regional hub. Right now we visited seven regional, right? And we got one day training, sometimes 2 days training. And with the 1 day or 2 day trainings, we set up like two parts. First part is about only technical about the Open edX system, because no one familiar with it yet. And with the corporate, with the TCU corporate with the Mahidol University. Mahidol University take care part of the technical training like that, right? But right now we try hard to make our human resource staff center to be a trainer also, because this is a new platform. And after we have more strong human resources inside, I mean TCU office center, so we will be a central for the support all regional. And this is the first part, right? The second part for the training is about the like a design or a production for the MOOC, different style that we do more, do some research by pick up some Coursera or edX experience, like the samples that we show, like video production style like that. So we try to explain what the teacher can do, whatever they want, but they need some more technical support, I mean the production team. So for the regional hub should support some kind of production also. So some regional offer themselves to be a center for a production, video production center, kind of that. But some, they just, okay, depends on the university, local university. If they can hire some production team or maybe self-made like that, so they can do it by themselves. So also by the late of September, we also cooperate with the Chiang Mai University. Dr. Anuchai also talked to, make agreement and proposal with the Chiang Mai University to make a pilot, right? A pilot MOOC course. So we got a very strong ID, knowledgeable professor. She is a professor at Chiang Mai University, and she's the first, I think, a top one of the ID field from us, Dr. Thanom Porn Lao Ha Jalat Sang from the Chiang Mai University, to make a pilot MOOC course for us. And then she after she make it done, she used it also in the Chiang Mai University for her students. And after that, we make a meeting to invite her to share experience what about the course development and the course implementation. So this is what we started at the early bird before the budget come. And then right now we try to focus four areas that also JMOOC, KMOOC already mentioned, and you go deep than us already, because your step go beyond us many steps. But however, I'm wanna what I say, we don't have QA standards, but we got guidelines to make sure that when the proposal comes, so this is a critical issue that you should concern and give budget to the local university. But we no contract, some kind of like JMOOC have or KMOOC have. We just contract a bit short, like 10 months contract to make it done. That's it. But after that, we will still like, okay, we will make a new phase later. But we learn from the two national country, I mean, two countries that, oh, okay, we should cover something more than that, right? And then for the MOOC course proposal agreement, we don't have clearly indicators to qualify or competitions, thing like that. But we give more empower to the regional to select to us based on five themes of subject. So that part we want to learn more from the two countries, okay? And for the MOOC course development, actually I have some, maybe I'm stop my part of QA, then I maybe make a round table first, you know, for the, because we want to learn more. And then I have from the four area, actually we focus four areas, but some questions or some issues still not clear for us yet. Like for the course proposal agreement, you call for proposal or invitation. So now we have some more answer already. You select some kind of top university and also make a call, proposal call too, right? Call for proposal too. And for the grant and contact, period of contract is different from us. Yeah, this is okay, we clear. And I have a question for the details of proposal and course syllabus. What are the critical indicators to approve a proposal? This is what I'm maybe give the question for the two countries. Please help us to clarify this, you know. I will go forward before and then come back later, okay? Because I got many issues, sorry. Yes. And for the MOOC course development, with high quality of content by selected lecturers, okay, we got answer. And then, but for us, maybe we have to make more adaptable with our culture, I think, because some selected cultures, for us, we have no ranking university inside, right? So maybe adaptable with Thai culture. Mm-hmm. And for this, the second issue is competencies of online instructor and the ID team. This morning, Dr. Tavani also asked Dr. Su, and Dr. Su said that, okay, he will strengthen this issue more for this year, right? And but actually for the experience from the instructor who familiar with the e-learning, maybe got more competency a bit more than the one who never be an online instructor. Mm-hmm. And for the quality learning materials, I heard from the some slides that you got not many details indicators to check up, like a QA team, right? Yeah, so this is what we have to set it up, more details than guidelines that we send to the term of reference before that guidelines. And also for the instructional design and for project management, this is some kind of insights of the TCU staff center, I think, because the project management have two parts. The part that have to hold to control and manage for the 140 courses will come back by 10 months later from now. I mean, 8 months later from now. No.
That's
March. March and April, okay. not too long. Yeah, that is the project management will be, you know, a bit. And what we have do right now, we just ask them to upload that first chapter or first week, first teaching hour in the sandbox system, that is like pilot one, to check. But from I heard this morning or that yesterday, this morning, we should check more and more, not only one. So this is a quality assurance that we needed more, I think. Yeah. And the copyright policy, Creative Commons issues, I want to learn more. We want to learn more about this. That's even though K-MOOC said that you got problem with the, still have a challenging with the copyright policy also, right? Like still got problem with this, but maybe more, not less than us, I think. Because for the Thai people, I mean, even Creative Commons is not well known yet. Yeah, it's not well known yet. And even though the professor in the university about the fair use, they're still not sure. Because in the university in Thailand, no declare of the university copyright policy. We don't declare it. We just said that it depends on the law, the law. I mean the national law. But actually, from the what I heard, I found from the American university, they set up, right, university policy, university copyright policy, and Creative Commons. So this is more educate the professor also, but for us, it depends on the department or faculties. So this is what the quality assurance that we have to make it later. And for this third part is the MOOC course implementation. This is what we gonna happen in the March this year. When we training them, we didn't mention much about this yet. But when we heard from the JMO and KMO, I learned more, and I add up some issues about like motivation strategies, not like just upload and then gone, you know. Some instructor and or teaching assistant have to be there and make think about the motivation strategy to adapt something. It depends on your students when they enroll. And a feedback, deep feedback or just yes or no is enough. Because some multiple choice or true false in the edX tools, we can choose just yes or no, it's okay. But I found that maybe get more motivation or more touch with the learner, you should get more, give more deep feedback. Deep feedback mean like more information that why you wrong, why you right, kind of that. And the teaching assistant roles, this what I discussed with Ajarn Anuchai, because we learned from you yesterday. And we didn't mention much about this yet. So we have to maybe training about the teaching assistant roles also to help how the instructor will run the course and the assessment of this student achievement in terms of methods and tools. We a bit freely depends on the university right now, but it has one issue inside our meeting. Our staff Kun Yui mentioned that one course only have pre-test and then post-test. So I asked her more, when you check up the proposal, did you find something like a quiz or something during the course? She said maybe not yet, because the storyboard is not come yet and the first chapter is not come yet, so she doesn't know exactly. But for a variety of the learning achievement, it's okay if you got pre and post, right? But I think it will fail for the interaction. The interaction part of the course, the quality of MOOC will fail because no interaction much. So maybe I think we need to looking for more details from that subject, okay? And from the university roles also, when we teach them how to use the OpenEdX platform, we doesn't talking about the back office, learning analytics yet. We just, this is how to upload, kind of that. But after the course run, right, after the implementation done, the TCU needs some kind of the data collection or report from the MOOC course, instructor that, okay, how many people comes and what interaction, how people still there or gone when they drop out, what week that they have left already, some kind of that. So this is what we need. So maybe we need some more also training about this part. Yeah, if not TCU, we cannot collect for the whole project data. Mm-hmm. This is the last part. The MOOC course evaluation, because we need some kind of learning interaction from the 140 courses to show as a whole picture of the Thai MOOC when we launched the first phase. The learner satisfaction, we need some kind of survey that maybe TCU have to set it up and spread it out to the 140 courses. and also checking up the drop out rate. Yeah, that's what we will try to make the standard and communicate to the 140 courses. So a lot more work, I think. So this is what I want to share. So as Dr. Chai be there, John Spani be there, could you please just like open some kind of round table? I want some idea from Jemu and Kimu also to help us. Yeah, thank you.
Can I add something about the maybe simple model of quality assurance? We do not have any standard or strong pattern of quality assurance, but we work together with the Hub University. We provide the guideline and then we help each other because this is the first phase, so it seems like a pilot and learning phase for us. So we provide the guideline and we work with the Hub University to try to encourage the university that develop the MOOC course to compile to the guideline for the quality assurance system. We try to ask the Hub University to be the first investigation for the quality of the MOOC course. When the university, member university, they produce the MOOC content, the Hub University will investigate first and try to make a recommendation to improve the quality of the course. And then after pass the Hub University, TCU also have a committee to looking for the quality of the course and make recommendation for improvement. But we did not have a very standard pattern of quality assurance. We try to learn and to improve step by step. So this is our system of maybe simple quality assurance. And also during the process, we learn from each other. We learn, we exchange information, we conduct a meeting among Hub University and TCU. We try to exchange and learn from each other. So maybe we develop step by step in as an information. We learn many new things or many good model from our Hub University also. So we try to collect a case, and Dr. Pravinya and team will collect good practice and maybe the pattern of quality assurance that we develop from time to time, and then create as a standard guideline that we will use on the second phase. And also in this expert forum, we learn a lot from all of you. Thank you very much. That is my information that I would like to add to Dr. Pravinya's presentation.
Thank you to Dr. Pravinya. From your presentation, I have seen that we have a long way to go, but the good thing is that we concerned about the quality, and then we know that what we lack. So we just try to learn and to gather everything together. It's a good thing because we start with knowing nothing and going to know more and more, learn more and more. And we know about our weak point. We know many. We have many weak point to improve to be better. Okay, thank you.
Any more comments or questions, please? Ajahn Kamulat.
I love the noisy meeting room, so I don't want any quiet. Okay, so the actually I would like to confess that I have very little knowledge about MOOC, but I have a passion, so I'm open to learn. And then by the 2 days, I'm very appreciate that I learn a lot. So I have observed that from the starting point of the K MOOC, J MOOC, or even the Thai MOOC, we have the similarity a lot. So the, for example, like for the Thai MOOC, it started up with the passion. We got the interest together. We got we know how what is the power of education to empowering our nation. So we work together. Like the KMOOC, they're saying that still a gap of higher education. It's the same to Thailand. We still have a gap. And then we also would like to empowering our people to be the digitized people. Kind of that. I found some similarity. And then the similarity. The other thing is the JMOOC, they start up with the demand serve. Okay, so we also start up with some demand serve. So I'm happy that we have the similarity among us. And then for the strategy, I got to learn something like for the NAI or the KMOOC. They're saying that at the beginning they tap with the bland university, with the famous university, and then that can work together to guarantee kind of the quality of the MOOC education. And then by the JMOOC, they're saying that they tap with the business, because business is more dynamic, kind of that, so it can move smoothly, kind of. For the Thai MOOC, we tap with the university, because TCU is saying that, hey, anyone that would like to join this adventure, come. We work for the good deeds together. We work to serve our country. So we show up the hand. So it's come up to be the blossom flower or the nationwide kind of. So I think that this is a strategy. We work with the heart and then tap the hands together and go together. And then the best practice that I have found out and observed is the JMOOC seem to be very practical. It's similar to our Thai situation, you know, because in our Thai MOOC, our budget is very swinging. It's not the we don't have. I might be wrong, but in the Thai MOOC system, we don't have the systematic or the constant budget for the Thai MOOC. It's a project based. It's happened because the Thai government want to digitize our people, kind of that. So it's come up. Next year it might gone. Kind of that. So I think that this is the reason why we try to seek out for the sustainable model, how to autonomize, how to sustain ourselves. So we learn we learn from JMOOC that why don't we use a membership model? Why don't we use the social enterprise model? And then we also use the cross certify. For example, like we work with the corporate, we work with the business. In the real world, the business have to confront with the real world, right? So business is the real. So if MOOC, our MOOC can serve the real business, can serve the real world, so meaning that by automatically, that MOOC is effective. And then it can be sellable, kind of that. So my brain keep jumping, and then, hey, we got some model from these 2 days. So I would like to say that my personal experience is the QA or the quality assurance. I think that since we learn a lot from this forum, why don't we set up kind of the platform, the e-platform among our ASEM, or I don't know how we call it, because I'm very new in this world. We set the sharing portal. What we learn from JMOOC, what we learn from KMOOC, what we learn from any other member country of ASEM MOOC, and then we share together. And then along the way, we set the standard about the MOOC among our own regional. And then we can cross, I mean, we can do the consortium, academy kind of that. And then our student, our learner will be very happy. I would like to take course in Vietnam. I would like to take course in Japan. I would like to take course in Malay. We can, kind of that. So I think that one among the QA is kind of socializing, mobilizing, sharing, and cross among our MOOC. That is what we are doing now. I'm the new, but I learn a lot from these 2 days because I learn a lot. So okay, it's confirmed my belief that the social enterprise model by the membership might be the solution. I'm the small teacher of the Open University. I have no power, I have nothing. But I'm saying that, okay, after this, I will pilot a very small MOOC and then set the kind of the autonomous center to move my own MOOC. Because I have the groundwork research that, hey, if your content is great, you can sell. It can be like a 500 baht, 300 baht per MOOC, and then they can use that knowledge in the real world, practical knowledge or digest knowledge, kind of that. So this is my challenge that I think that the MOOC is really, really a magic that can let us learn from each other. Why don't we help each other and then do the QA together with a friendship base? And then once the sharing among the region can be consensus, meaning that we have our own regional QA system by our big brother, KMOOC, JMOOC, and other country that a little bit older from us. Because I also observed that JMOOC, KMOOC just start in the year of 2000-something. Right? We are the same brother, sister. It's not like a grandfather kind of that. So we can tap the hands and go together kind of that. So that's my part. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Very lovely comments. Any more, Professor Yoshimi?
Thank you very much for a very nice presentation. from the JMOOC side, we have we can offer the anything we have and the as possible we can because of the very we are very the open mind open and as I mentioned the main purpose of the JMOOC is the one of the our aims is to cooperate in Asia each other, so it's the one of the our aims, main aims, and regarding the QA quality assurance, it's my personal opinion, but please suppose the even for the university courses, the it's responsible for university. So they're very limited thing we can do for the assure the quality of the courses provided by the university. Once the university decided to provide the course, have the responsibility for that course, and the course is already provided for the from the university. So it's the content the side, the term quality. This is consists of the some structure. So the contents and maybe the format or so physical layer. Maybe we should stick to the physical layer. So it's a very a good quality to keep the running effectively. So the from the our side, we are very much stick to the quality of the physical layers, contents of the physical layer or contents physical layers quality, but the content itself, I think it's the so university's problem. And in the in Japan, the to join the for the university, the requirements for the joining as a member, the approval of the university level is required. So the once the university become the member of the JMOOC, the matters the university handling regarding the JMOOC is the based on the university level approval after the university level approval. So I think the it's only to think the nervously too much. So and one more thing is we stick to the learners' centers. So we think it's very important to keep the learners' satisfaction more good learners' satisfaction. So. Of course, we should the learners and the universities also the both are stakeholders. But the learners' satisfaction is much more important than the university satisfaction. It's our opinion. Thank you.
Any more comment, please, or advice? This is round table. We have this round. That round is very quiet. Not Professor Supani. These three distinguished. Hok Lok Siu never speak up. Okay, I have some comment to add on, please. For Thai MOOC, we focus on team building. We learn from each other. For example, my university attached to Chulalongkorn University. Chulalongkorn is the hub. And we have to work together collaboratively with other universities. For this hub, we have 13 courses on offer. And we learn how to, say, do video shooting. We do have some lecturers who use that simple web camera and take video shooting. We do have lecturers who have very big studio. And then we show up our work and we learn from each other. That is what really important. Second thing is for the quality assurance on copyright, at the moment Thai MOOC Daddy has published a guideline on declaration. We will declare the video content as CC BY NC SA as a minimum, Creative Commons, non-commercial, and SA share-alike. Or if someone don't want any modification, they can call CC BY NC ND, non-derivatives. So for that, at least now, many instructors and content developers realize the importance of copyright. So that is something that we learn together, and hopefully one day it will become quality assurance, and it will fit in one of the boxes that Dr. Pavinya is showing us. I think it will show up in the gray box. So one day Thai MOOC will add that to this bit. When second phase, he asked me when. I hope that by second phase, then we can learn. Because right now, even Thai font, there are some companies who own the font start suing Thai University of copyright infringement. Because if we make content and we use for our class, teaching inside our class, nobody knows. But for Thai MOOC, it is kind of public. For example, his courses, if I have interest, I can enroll in the first phase for free. So I can download. By all means, it is MOOC. It is going to be available on 8X. So I can even download. So that is a way that those companies will come and check for copyright. And it could be a big headache. So this is a big step towards quality assurance for Thai MOOC.
And on the font thing. The font now in Thailand, they have so many problems on that one. In my university, we have that problem of the font. When we try to do some kind of video, and they say that that's not our font. So finally, what we do is we buy that font. So we bought it. We have some agreement, which is quite okay. They're saying that we can use it unlimited for, how much is it? 200,000 baht under the name of the university. So if we put our university's name on the content, so it's okay. So we get 1,000 font from that one for 200,000. Yeah. So it's quite expensive. Another thing that I want to add on the one of the quality assurance is the credit transfer. If we're thinking of the if it's really a quality course, so it should be able to transfer to other university. One of the mean that I can think of is the AUN thing, AUNACTS. Maybe later you can plus three, plus four later on Japan and Korea. Right now in ASEAN, we can do a credit transfer between AUN, which is quite easy. And in Prince of Songkhla University, we have a lot of students that go to Indonesia for study and then transfer it back, go to Malaysia, which is very close to them. And MOOC can be one. And the student don't need to travel. They can study in on their own and do some kind of transfer. Even now, we do a transfer to European country, and we're using that ECTS thing to transfer back. So that's my comment on that one. Thank you.
One more question. One more comment from the gym about the intellectual property rights. So in Japan, it's something a national problem. The intellectual property for the educational use, the contents for educational use. Right now the Japanese law is very rigid for the keeping the rights of the contents holders very much stronger. It's very difficult to open from the outside, just only for the classroom use is allowed for the contents. It's very difficult for to make more open for use of for the education for educational use. It's the long time discussing, continuing discussing. Maybe it's very difficult to change drastically in a short term. And so activity we made for the this copyright issue, intellectual property issue, we put the help desk about the copyright issue for the universities, So if the university have the something problem or some question about the copyright, they can access to the help desk. We asked some experts company to provide the support. That's one thing, and the other thing is the comprehensive contract we have for the use of the big contents holders. It's the French company AFP. We have JMOOC have the comprehensive contract. Though they are, if the our member university use the for the MOOC contents, they can use their any kind of AFP contents for free. Of course, it's not free. We pay totally. So it's one of the solution one of the support provided for the university for creating our contents. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we learn another model from that JMOOC. And any more discussion, please, before we go to the break? Just briefly explain about the program remaining today. We are going to have a break after this, and then we will listen to Professor Han's presentation on Korea MOOC's example, a case study, and then we will wrap up the event. So that will be the end. So please, if you have anything to discuss, after listening to, since the morning, Professor So, who gave insight on quality assurance from Korea, Professor Im, quality assurance from, Professor Yoshimi from Japan, and Dr. Vinaya on Thailand. Is there anything else you would like to comment or to say based on your experience? Or is there anything you really want to see it happening for our future?
I think today is very informative to all of us, and because we are planning to do a MOU together among our three MOOCs, so maybe this is a very good starting step that we try to align our way of practice of the MOOC education. So I think that we can closely align, and maybe that will be benefit for further maybe cross-border education or accreditation or credit transfer in the future, maybe. But at least we can make our MOOC content maybe a little bit comparable of the quality. Maybe in Thai side, maybe we a little bit behind JMOOC or KMOOC, but we try to catch up. And maybe we can have an equal quality in the near future. Yeah, thank you very much.
May I add a little bit? Because just a quick one. After professor has talked about the kinds of more add up, I observed that it found out the model of working, sustainable working, is kind of a partnership model. For example, like you're saying that for the JMOOC, if any university help contribute the content, and then the lecturer in that university can make use that MOOC for free. Have that, I feel very appreciate, you know, because if the professor have a very effective production MOOC, they can use it for their student in university, and the JMOOC also can offer that effective MOOC to the society kind of. So I think that that is very interesting that we partners and then we offer the win-win win-win strategy. You give, I take, you give, and then we win together. And then let me think further step, like we really want to do kinds of credit transfer or consortium or exchange or kind of that. Since KMOOC and JMOOC already professional one, I was saying that. Is there any policy that we partner across the university, across the MOOC? For example, like the KMOOC work as a partner with the Thai MOOC, JMOOC, and then in each particular topic based to their readiness, kind of that. Then the content is certified because we work together. And then I think that this is a dream. I don't know, but if like this, so meaning that it's automatically cross and collaborate. I don't know. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much for another very good comment. And how about Dr. Pominya, the owner of this session? You have anything to add on, please?
What I want to say thank you again for the two nations, because when we cooperate together, what we have talked from the TCU staff is the quality of Thai MOOC should be equally to the other countries. When the transfer, the credit transfer come that time, I mean, maybe the time is coming later again. Okay, some people will take us, I mean, take our courses also to try to make credit transfer. But right now, the QA step of us still lag behind. But we know what we want to improve. So in the near future, so after we learn and then improve more and more, so I think one day we will get a same standard with two countries. So thank you very much again. Thank you.
If no...